Okay, let's have a look at right. Skill points. I might tweak this even more because I only changed this. Oops. Let's have a look. Change to PvP. Okay, it's lightning. Hang on a sec, has this changed? I switched between two devices. I've noticed that a bug, something's right, okay. Yeah, okay, lightning. All in offense, nothing in wisdom. Good concentration, fatality, mostly full. Wisdom is at zero because basically this is a follow-up skill to do more damage. So I basically use either a bubble or my 52 skill to engage, and I need those two skills to have as much cooldown as possible. So this one's kind of pretty much maxed out. You'll notice my concentration is at 6-7. That's because that's me at 100%. There's no point adding another skill point there because I've not tested it out. I'm not 100% sure, but if you can go over 100%, basically because he gets crit resist, so it's, does 110 give you 55 back if the opponent has 50% crit resist? I'm not sure, but I'm assuming it doesn't. I'm assuming it caps out at 100%. So 6-7 for concentration means I'm at 100% for skills. It's the same with circle here. Maximized everything here. Combos are pretty low. It's just all in damage. 4-4-4. Passives are generally what you get for pretty much every PvP player. Unless you play a counter build, I don't recommend it unless you have a really good connection. One or two of our members in the guild play counter and they're really good at it. Essentially, with counter, you can get additional cooldown, additional damage, additional HP. It's really good if you can pull it off. But essentially, if you don't play counter, nothing on counter. And the top just basically looks like that. Blocking is normally at 5-5, but I've been tweaking my costumes to max out at 30, which is why it's been reduced. Same idea, you know. There's no point putting in more skill points if it goes over the maximum. Down the bottom, I've maximized melee reduction because it's melee characters that do the most damage. And having a look at my stats altogether. Let's have a look at PvP. Well, I'll have a look at the gear. You can see I'm using Touch of Seduction. Some players might be wondering why I'm using Season 2. It's the attack is less, but for PvP, the weighting for how much damage you do is mainly to do with critical rate, and you really want as much critical rate as possible. Now this is a weapon I'm using, so maximizing as much critical rate as possible, and you can see I've spec'd in chance to recover HP. That's so useful, especially for ranged characters. You can see from my gameplays I'm now getting 170k per hit, and because my mitigation is so high, I could basically undo, the damage that enemies do to me. The season 3 raise, that was only there for 1 week. Lots of players managed to take advantage of that and get lots of stuff in there. You can see I managed to get thinking of building a disciplinary thorn for PvE, and that's good. It'll take a lot of resources. Maybe there isn't much point. I really wanted to get this Kiki up in the seal defense, but having a look at the top 100 seal defense, you don't see any Kikis or hardly any Kikis. It's just Kikis still do very little damage. Just have a look at the stats now. That's my total stats here. The armor I'm using is this one, the crit resist. That's purely to maximize mitigation, get as much crit resist, get as much HP, and then with the HP I can recover it back as well. The third affix, where it says PvP, increased damage dealt on defending enemy by 250%, it's absolutely bollocks, it's rubbish. tested it out. It would be good if it kind of worked with enemies evading or skilling. It doesn't. I've tested it out. It only works if the enemy is specifically blocking, and you don't get, you know, you hardly get people who block. That's basically because people don't play counter builds, and I reckon really that's a whole game mechanic that people are not playing with. Counters are good, but it's just not worth the risk playing counters. Really like to see counters in the game more often, but it's just too risky. It's the better thing to do is just to skill away, reposition, and wait for your cooldowns. Right, I used to use the Agate Magic Stone. That was before the last patch. Now I'm back to using more damage. I think damage has become more important now. Crest wise, I'm using the Worker's Crest for more HP on hit. And if you look at my stats, a chance to drain HP is 12.5. It's not maxed out. I could max it out, but I decided not to. It's just overkill. I decided to put in more damage, more criticals. Because 12.5 giving me back 170k per HP is enough, really. My damage reduction 17.5, melee 25, PvP damage reduction of 30. It's all very high here. Still take I can tank a lot, but with this recent patch, my HP is going down faster than before. Criticals could be a bit higher. I could probably take up to 75 at some point. I've tweaked my costumes now. Let's have a look at the costumes. Pretty much all the costumes have both PvPs and a chance to recover HP. One or two of them has more additional damage related affixes. The wing here. Try to get the new wings, but that's a right pain in the ass trying to get. Those wing packs are horrendous. Probably the worst trolls, in terms of RNG. Generally get rubbish, five shiny bags and they're all legendaries. That's quite a common thing to get with wing packs. Cloaks are hard to get. I reckon we'll get an upgrade with wing cloaks. It's been a long time since there's been new cloaks. We should probably see a new cloak with fixed affixes. Maybe crypt resist or something like that. PvP, I don't know. But, this current refresh of costumes are really good with the two, critical rate resist and increased damage. I really recommend investing into a crit rate resist, because I would reckon that's pretty much the most important affix in for PvP, and you can tell whether a player is new to Guild Wars and PvP by how much crit resist they have. Because people who don't play PvP or are new to PvP have really low crit rate resists, because it doesn't give you any more bonuses or it doesn't add anything more to PvE, and that's, lots of players play PvE and then when they get bored of that, then they move to PvP. Then suddenly realize, oh no, I've trained all the wrong things. They've probably put everything into attack. Now the first three, attack, agility, and defense. I've storing up tickets now. I don't even need. I've got 46 tickets. I could stick it into these two, but I've decided to save these tickets up now. The reason is because South Korea has made it so that it's only one ticket per upgrade from 30 onwards, so I'm just going to dump all that in to these two once that comes over to global. I can probably start putting in 102 maybe. No, I'll just leave it. Don't need it. Defense and attack is more PvE related stats. The important stats is reflexes. You really want that as high as possible. But like I said, it doesn't add anything to PvE. The bottom row stats. The concentration and fatality adds a wee bit, but these are great for PvE, PvP, and health as well. 800. It all adds up. Make sure you're training properly. Don't stick it all in defense and attack and attacks, especially attack speed. Just take that up to 30. In fact, I had my attack speed up to 20 for months. Actually, I only just took it up to 30 because I had so many tickets. Right,